Good morning, students. In the previous video, we have learnt about the average income, that is per capita income. In part 1, we have studied the meaning of development and the different developmental goals. Today, in this video, we are going to learn about income and other criteria. Before I begin with the session, I want you all to take out your books and pens so that you can jot down some important points. Let's start. Income and other criteria. Individuals' aspirations and goals. People not only want better income, they also want security, respect for others, equal treatment, freedom, etc. Students, in part 1 I had already taught you that income is not everything, right? People also wish for security, respect for others, equal treatment and freedom. Similarly, for nation or region, average income is not enough. Then, what is important? There are few other equally important attributes. Today, in this video, we are going to learn about the other equally important attributes. Let's see. Some criteria other than income used to compare development are: number 1, infant mortality rate; number 2, literacy rate; number 3, net attendance ratio. Now we are going to learn in detail about these attributes. Infant mortality rate. Students, do you know what you mean by infant mortality rate? Infant mortality rate indicates the number of children that die before the age of 1 year as a proportion of 1,000 live children born in that particular year. Students, what is this infant mortality rate? The number of children that die even before they celebrate their first birthday. Okay, and what's the proportion? As a proportion of 1,000 live children born in that particular year. So you just imagine about the parents whose children they die before they celebrate their first birthday. How painful it would be for the parents, right? So I hope it's clear. Infant mortality rate, it indicates the number of children that die before the age of 1 year as a proportion of 1,000 live children born in that particular year. Let's move to the other attribute, literacy rate. Students, do you know what is literacy rate? Okay, whom do you call a literate person? Literate person, a person about 7 years and he or she is able to read and write with understanding can be termed as a literate person. So here literacy rate means it measures the proportion of literate population in the 7 and above age group. Okay, so the country would be developed if the literacy rate of that particular country is high. Okay, now next we are going to deal with net attendance ratio. Students, do you know what you mean by net attendance ratio? Let's see. It is the total number of children of age group 14 and 15 years attending school as a total number of children in the same age group. So what is net attendance ratio, students? Children, those who study beyond 8th standard. Okay, it is the total number of children of age group 14 and 15 years attending school as a total number of children in the same age group. So the country to be developed, it requires high net attendance ratio. So till now we have studied about the infant mortality rate, Students, what do you think? Infant mortality rate should be high or low for the country to be developed? Yes, it should be low. Why? Because it indicates the number of children, those who die before they attend or before they celebrate their first birthday. Okay, so the infant mortality rate should be low for the country to be developed. And what about literacy rate? Yes, it should be high. And what about net attendance ratio? Yes, even net attendance ratio should be high. So these three attributes we have studied, right? Infant mortality rate, literacy rate, and net attendance ratio. Now, let us compare the three states on the basis of per capita income. Okay, so here we have three states, Maharashtra, Kerala, and Bihar. So let's see the per capita income for the year 2013-14. Okay, for the state of Maharashtra, it is 1,17,091, and for Kerala it is 1,03,820, and for Bihar it is 31,199. So by looking at this table, what conclusion can be drawn? Yes, Maharashtra's per capita income is higher than Kerala and Bihar. So Maharashtra ranks first, Kerala ranks second, and Bihar ranks third in terms of per capita income. So suppose we want to compare these three states on the basis of per capita income, then of course Maharashtra will be the most developed and Bihar would be the least developed. Okay, so let's compare these three states on the basis of some other criteria like infant mortality rate, literacy rate, and net attendance ratio. Let's see infant mortality rate. Students, we have already learnt about this, right? You all know what is infant mortality rate. Now let us compare these three states in terms of infant mortality rate. Okay, this data is of the year 2013. So when we see Maharashtra's infant mortality rate, it is 24, Kerala's 12, Bihar 42. So Kerala's infant mortality rate is quite low, which is a good indicator of development, whereas Bihar's infant mortality rate is 42, which is not a good indicator of development. Okay, in the previous slide we had learned that Maharashtra's per capita income was too high, right? And it was termed as the most developed state. But when we compare these three states in terms of infant mortality rate, then Kerala is at the top. Okay, Kerala will be the most developed out of these three. Now let's move on to the next attribute, that is literacy rate. Let us compare these three states again in terms of literacy rate. Students, I had already explained you about the literacy rate, right? Now let's see the literacy rate of Maharashtra. This data is as per 2011. Maharashtra's literacy rate is 82, Kerala's 94, and Bihar 62. So again here, Kerala ranks first, right? Why? Because its literacy rate is 94%. So again Kerala ranks first, isn't it, students? So when we compare these three states in terms of literacy rate, again Kerala ranks first. So it's very clear that Kerala is more developed than Maharashtra and Bihar. Let us compare these three states in terms of net attendance ratio. Okay, so Maharashtra's net attendance ratio is 64, Kerala's 78, and Bihar's it is 35. So once again, Kerala ranks first in terms of net attendance ratio. So again, Kerala is at the top. Is that clear, students? So when we compare these three states in terms of infant mortality rate, literacy rate, and net attendance ratio, then Kerala ranks first. It is the most developed. Okay, it is developed than Maharashtra and Bihar. Students, till now we have compared Maharashtra, Bihar, and Kerala in terms of per capita income, net attendance ratio, infant mortality rate, and literacy rate. And we have come to a conclusion that Kerala is the most developed one, isn't it? Because its infant mortality rate was low, net attendance ratio as well as literacy rate was higher than Maharashtra and Bihar. Okay, now we will move further to the next topic. Students, do you know what you mean by public facilities? Facilities which are provided by the government is considered as public facility, like schools, hospitals, transport, electricity, etc. Students, do you know these public facilities play a very important role in the development of a region? The advantage of a public facility is that once it is provided, its benefits can be shared by many people. For example, a school in the village will enable many children to get educated. But do you think for one child the government would take initiative in establishing schools? Definitely not. When many other children desire to get education, then only the government will take steps to open schools. Not only school students, even hospitals, transportation facilities provided by the government. We need public facilities because we are not able to purchase all things by money. Can we purchase everything with the help of money? Certainly no. We cannot able to buy a pollution-free environment with the help of money. Students, you have sufficient money and you think of purchasing pollution-free environment. Is that possible? Certainly no. So money is important, but with the help of money you cannot purchase everything, right? So public facilities is also very important. Kerala with lower per capita income is more developed than Maharashtra. Hence, per capita income is not a useful criteria at all in comparing states. Now, Kerala is more developed than Maharashtra because it has got good educational facilities as well as better health facilities. Now, let's move on to the next topic. Public distribution system. Public distribution system is a government-sponsored chain of shops entrusted with the work of distributing basic food and non-food commodities to the needy sections of the society at very cheap prices. Students, you may be knowing ration shops, right? Wherein the needy people, okay, the poor people, they obtain food and non-food commodities at a subsidized price, that is, at a very cheap rate, cheaper than the market price. So public distribution system is also very important for the development of a region. Now, public distribution system, through public distribution system, people can get wheat, rice, kerosene, sugar, etc. at a cheap rate. In some states, the public distribution system functions well. That's why health and nutritional status of people of such states is certainly likely to be better. Students, here is one interesting activity for you. I have taken this activity from your economics NCERT textbook, page number 12. Study the table carefully and fill in the blanks in the following paragraphs. For this, you may need to make calculations based on the table. Educational achievement of rural population of Uttar Pradesh. Literacy rate for rural population, male 76%, female 54%. Literacy rate for rural children in age group 10 to 14 years, male 90%, female 87%. Percentage of rural children aged 10 to 14 attending school, male 85%, female 82%. After reading this table, students, you need to fill in the blanks in the following paragraphs. When the school will reopen, we will be discussing the answers. Okay, this will be homework for you. Now, it's quiz time. Question number one. Development of a country can generally be determined by dash. Option A, its per capita income. Option B, its average literacy level. Option C, health status of its people. Option D, all of the above. And the correct answer is option D, all of the above. Next question. What are PDS shops? Option A, rice shops. Option B, wheat shops. Option C, ration shops. Option D, kerosene shops. And the correct answer is option C, ration shops. Next question. Which of the following is true for Kerala's infant mortality rate? Option A, infant mortality rate is high. Option B, infant mortality rate is low. Option C, infant mortality rate is medium. Option D, infant mortality rate is average. And the correct answer is option B, infant mortality rate is low. Next question. PDS, that is public distribution system, should function properly in a country like India where there are more poor people because option A, it should give shelter to maximum poor people. Option B, it should provide employment to the poor. Option C, it should benefit the maximum poor in the country. Option D, it should benefit maximum poor with education facilities. And the correct answer is option C, it should benefit the maximum poor in the country. Next question. Which of the following is not true for a developed country? Option A, high per capita income. Option B, high infant mortality rate. Option C, high literacy rate. Option D, high school attendance ratio. And the correct option is high infant mortality rate. ऑप्शन बी हाई इन्फेंट मॉर्टेलिटी रेट. लेट्स डू द रीकैप नाउ. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट इन्फेंट मॉर्टेलिटी रेट. इन्फेंट मॉर्टेलिटी रेट इंडिकेट्स द नंबर ऑफ चिल्ड्रेन दैट डाई बिफोर द एज ऑफ 1 year as a proportion of 1,000 live children born in that particular area. Next, we have studied about literacy rate. Literacy rate measures the proportion of literate population in the 7 and above age group. We have studied about net attendance ratio. Net attendance ratio is the total number of children of age group 14 and 15 years attending school as a percentage of total number of children in the same age group. We have also learnt about public facilities, the facilities provided by the government for the welfare of the public. Hope you all have understood the topics covered today. The remaining topics we will be covering in the next video. In this slide, I am sharing with you all a link through which you can access the video for the topics covered today. Hope you enjoy the video. Please don't forget to read the textbook. Meet you in the next video. Till then, bye and take care.